anyone else think this is the craziest thing ever, or is it just me? Be a published author in 1 minute flat. You can now create personalized illustrated stories with read aloud narration in Gemini. Yes, really. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and this is my favorite Gemini update in a long time, so let's jump right into it. First, if it's been a minute since you've accessed Gemini on the web, you're gonna notice your new chat prompt bar is now located front and center for you with a tools toggle where you can create videos, dive into deep research or Canvas, you can create images, or enter a guided learning prompt. There are also quick access buttons under the prompt bar as well. But we both know, that's not the Gemini update you came here for. Nay, we're going to create a storybook together. So here's how to create a personalized story with Gemini Storybook. And yes, there are a couple of ways to do this. The easiest way to access Storybook is from this main Gemini prompt bar. All you have to do is write, create a storybook about, and then you're gonna fill in what you'd like to create. So let's keep it simple for this first example. And we're gonna say, create a storybook that explains recycling to my five-year-old niece. We'll just leave it at that. Let's hit enter and see what we get. Gemini Storybook starts by creating an initial draft and then creating illustrations for your book. And the whole process only took quite literally under a minute and a half. So let's check out this result together. Here we are on our cover page of my book, and it explains recycling to a five-year-old, just like I have asked. Now, in the left panel, we've got my initial prompt. We are told Storybook is experimental, and we can see that Gemini has created this book for us on this date and time. And here's what it's called, The Adventure of the Colorful Bins. And look here to this cover page. It's got the title with me, Tasia Custode, as the author, so it has pulled that info right from my Google profile. Now, is it technically by me? No, but the idea was mine, and it's mine now, so semantics? Anyway, you can use the arrows at the top to scroll through the storybook, or you can simply click on it near the right to flip the pages. So let's do that and read a little bit of it. Leo and Lily loved to play. They built forts with pillows and raced cars across the floor. One morning, their mom called, "Time for a new adventure, my little helpers." Okay, you get the idea here. Let's keep flipping through this book. All right, this really isn't bad for under a minute and a half. You can see that it is trying very hard with consistency throughout the storybook. So if we want to nitpick, as we do on this channel, we can see some of the subtle differences in what Lily is wearing in one scene. She's got a headband on, in others she doesn't. The mom has socks, then doesn't. Same with Lily's shoes in a scene. But this is really pretty impressive generation in under a minute and a half. When you're navigating from your storybook page, you can also hover near the left side of the book and click to go back a page as well. You can also view your storybook full screen by clicking on the full screen button near the top right, or you can then flip through your book with it popped out and centered. You can exit full screen by just clicking that X in the top left, and that's gonna pop you back into this kind of canvas storybook layout. Now, also up near the top right is where you can click to share and export your storybook. Clicking share will create a shareable public link that, yes, is viewable to anyone, even if they don't have Gemini. Or you can share it to a social media platform from here too. But you can also print your storybook from here too, all with a click. You could literally be a published author in about a minute. That's wild. Anyone else think this is the craziest thing ever, or is it just me? But you can also listen to your storybook in Gemini as well. Click on listen near the top right, and this will pop out the storybook to full screen, and a narration will automatically begin.
The Adventure of the Colorful Bins. Leo and Lily love to play. They built forts with pillows and raced cars across the floor. One morning, their mom called, "Time for a new adventure, my little helpers." Mom brought three big, colorful bins into the room. One was bright blue.
I'm gonna pause this here because you can also click on that down arrow in the top right to adjust the pitch of the voice, start from the beginning, or toggle off the option to listen in full screen. As of right now, storybooks are 10 pages long, and you might remember me saying at the top of this video that there is more than one way to access Storybook in Gemini. So let's say you tried this method of simply prompting Gemini to create a story about something, and for some reason, it didn't work. Stranger things have happened. Well, let me show you another way to create a storybook in Gemini. Click on that hamburger menu in the top left corner. Now here under Gems, you might already see a storybook option. So if you do, you're gonna click that. But if you don't see a storybook option, click on the Explore Gems option. Right up here at the top, you should have that storybook option under the pre-made Google Gems. All you need to do is simply click on the storybook option, and now your prompt page should look something like this, where you can create a storybook. And you're even given some examples here, and you can see this is where you'd create that custom picture book for children or adults. And yes, you can upload images and files as part of your prompt. You can ask Gemini for certain illustrative styles. You can ask for the book in all languages that Gemini is available in. You can even ask Gemini to make your storybook a coloring book. So with all that in mind, let's try a little bit more of an advanced prompt and see how Gemini does. Let's create a storybook about my nephew's favorite stuffed animal penguin named Pengy. We're gonna make it an adventure book with Pengy traveling from Antarctica to Southern California to be reunited with my nephew, Austin. Here are a few pictures of Pengy. And now I'm just going to use that plus symbol and I'm gonna add the photos of Pengy that I have. We'll hit enter and we're gonna cross our fingers that Gemini can recreate Pengy or a version of Pengy in this book. But you can see how this is a much more detailed, personalized prompt than that first example. And once again, this took about a minute to generate. And moment of truth, oh my gosh, will you look at this Pengy's grand adventure. Without further ado, let's click to flip through this new storybook. Austin and his best friend, a stuffed penguin named Pengy, were on a boat adventure to see the giant ice mountains of Antarctica. Austin hugged Pengy tight. "We'll always be together," he whispered into Pengy's soft gray fur. Oh my God, I think I'm going to cry. But really, this story is so cute. So it knows it has gray fur, though there are some consistency issues with Pengy, you know, the eyes and the stitching and such. But who's complaining for a picture book made in about a minute? And yes, because I know you're wondering, spoiler alert, Pengy and Austin were happily reunited in the end. So as another quick example, I also created this adult coloring book detailing my time at the Eras tour with my niece, and I made it specifically for her, and holy moly, my prompt was so detailed. So seriously, look at the prompt that I gave Gemini, and I even included some reference photos as well. And check out this coloring book Gemini made in, again, about a minute. You guys, it even grabbed a lot of the details from those photos, including Taylor's snake bodysuit from the rep era. And there's the folklore cabin. It's all too much. Wow. All right, so what happens if you're not happy with the storybook and you want to edit it or recreate it? Take this example I did where I uploaded my resume and I asked Gemini to create a storybook explaining my career to my five-year-old niece. You can see it misunderstood the assignment by giving me a daughter, which is... oof. Anyway, it's also got me with dark hair, so it wasn't able to pull from my Google profile for reference to what I look like. And as of right now, here's what you would need to do. You would need to re-prompt, and it would regenerate the entire book. There isn't currently a way to edit specific page contents, at least as of right now. So Gemini, if you're listening, we'd love to see that added. We being me. Just a little way to make this even better. I don't know how it's possible, but that's for smarter minds than me to figure out. Okay, so let's use this recycling book as an example. What's nice is that you can ask for the revision you want, and then even though Gemini regenerates an entirely new book, so here is my updated title like I asked, and there's new illustrations, and there's new text, all is not lost. You can scroll back through your chat and open up older versions of the book. So you never have to worry about losing the original version. I just love that. And yes, you get a shareable link that is unique to that book version. And in terms of availability, Gemini Storybook is rolling out to mobile as we speak. And remember, it's available in all languages that Gemini is available in. And it's also available to all Gemini users over the age of 18. How neat is that? I've linked to a great overview page in the description below if you want even more info on Storybook. But really think of all the use cases here. This is so great for birthday gifts, anniversaries, friendiversaries. Maybe you want to make a trip highlights book. Maybe you want to do adult coloring books or publish children's books in about a minute flat. Maybe you want to make a custom book for a job application. Seriously, upload your resume and tailor a storybook to a potential employer. Come on, how unique is that? There are so many use cases. So I'm really curious to know how you will use Storybook in Gemini. Let everyone know in the comments below and let's compare our storybook ideas. I still can't believe if I technically became a published author just like that. And now I want to hear from you. What do you think of Storybook? And what type of stories are you creating? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gemini goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time.